This segment is on hydraulic fracturing and the chemicals used. There are specific criteria for choosing a particular set of chemicals for a frac job. Safety, minimal exposure danger. Environmentally friendly, be as green as possible. An effective breaker, the viscous fluid which carries the sand must break or become less viscous to allow cleanup of the fracture zone. Cost, it must be economical. Compatibility, chemicals chosen must not adversely interact with or damage the formation or the function of the other fluids. And it must be easy to mix, even under adverse conditions, such as North Dakota in winter. How much water and how much chemicals? The proportion of added chemical is usually less than 1% of the total. As with most things related to oil and gas operations, it varies, but generally it is less than 1%. The proportions shown here are averages, and the various types of chemicals and their purpose is also shown. Besides water, the major constituents are acid, friction reducers, and surfactants. Other constituents include gelling agents, scale inhibitors, pH adjusting agents, iron control, corrosion inhibitors, and biocides. With respect to chemicals used in hydraulic fracturing, there are two relevant environmental acts. The first is the toxic release inventory. This is Section 313 of the Emergency Planning and Community Right to Know Act. Community Right to Know reporting on hazardous and toxic chemicals is required. EPA has now included oil and gas industry as an industry that must report these chemicals. The second act is the Comprehensive Environmental Response, Compensation, and Liability Act of 1980, CERCLA, or as most people know it, Superfund. Some chemicals used are classified as hazardous under CERCLA and are required to be reported when they exceed certain thresholds and are released into the atmosphere, surface water, groundwater, soils, things like spills.